This review was prepared by Katina Michael and Roba Abbas and published by TheoryHub. TheoryHub covers a wide range of theories and acts as a starting point for theory exploration in different research and teaching and learning contexts. This is a review of the Evolutionary Economic Theory. Evolutionary economics explains change over time with respect to economic development. Economic theory is the study of how economies work. Evolutionary economics is broadly concerned with how economic change occurs and is focused on innovation and entrepreneurship, industrial and institutional dynamics, and on patterns and trends as they relate to economic growth and development. Fundamental to the ideology of evolutionary economics is that innovation and economic change are intertwined. Theorists employing an evolutionary economic approach are typically concerned with economic growth, productivity, and stakeholder interactions. Planners that adopt principles of evolutionary economics are concerned with infrastructural, structural, and institutional changes and impacts over time. Practitioners, on the other hand, most of whom manage technology development, focus on innovation processes and systems of innovation and technological change as it might impact on economic development. Central to evolutionary economics is the notion that the world is complex and dynamic. Accordingly, Metcalfe proclaims that innovation-driven economic processes are open-ended with the economy never in equilibrium, or even close to equilibrium. Outcomes are to be discovered, not presumed in advance of an event. Thus, evolutionary economics is said to be non-directed, lacking predetermination to a given endpoint. As innovation is considered on a continuum over time and as a phenomenon that is unfolding, stakeholders are engaged in a practice of co-evolution where they are building together a knowledge program through the exchange of thoughts and imagination. In this innovation environment, technologies impact the way supplies are procured and goods are produced, and consequently, organizations and citizens have to co-evolve in larger processes to observe technologies in continuity. Co-evolution comes into practice when several evolving domains or areas within a socio-economic system reciprocally impact one another's innovation, reproduction, or choices. In effect, co-evolution can be analyzed as a process at a global level, demonstrating dynamic co-determination toward shared agreement between stakeholders. The interdependencies and interconnections between clusters of stakeholders yield the creative ability to co-create. Evolutionary economic theory has made possible the reinterpretation of microeconomics and macroeconomics using evolutionary concepts and ideas. It proposes that economic and industrial processes emerge over time, driven by humans who assemble into communities within society at large and for the greater part they self-organize. It is humans who together are able to conceive of new innovations that can be designed and implemented. The study of evolutionary economics is wide-ranging and may be located in any number of disciplines or schools. The parent theory of evolutionary economic theory is evolutionary theory, attributed to Charles Darwin, who published On the Origin of Species in 1859, focused on natural selection. Relevant to evolutionary economic theory, Thorstein Bunde Veblen is widely considered the founding father of the evolutionary institutional paradigm, and to whom can be attributed the first coining of the term evolutionary economics in English. Veblen did not believe that neoclassical economics could be considered a modern science, since it predated Darwinian thinking. Neoclassical economics is concerned with the production function, viewing advances in technology as fueling economic growth by lowering the cost of making an output. Veblen recognized that the fundamental weakness of neoclassical economics was that only prices and volumes matter. He applied evolutionary biological concepts to economics and noted that the process of change, in the definitive formulation of knowledge, was a gradual one. Unlike traditional economics, which used rational choice theory, Veblenian evolutionary economics argued that human nature, namely anthropological and psychological factors, were the key drivers of the economy. Evolutionary economic theory is defined in the seminal work of Nelson and Winter, and is now part of mainstream economics, developed as an alternative to neoclassical theory, which was strongly inspired by Schumpeter's theory of economic development. Nelson and Winter claimed that firms are not profit maximizers but follow rather rigid rules or routines, and agents, including managers, are only boundedly rational. In the context of innovation, evolutionary economic theory views technical change as something other than an attempt to maximize profits and is characterized by the concepts of reproduction, variety, and selection. Technological advancement is considered a key driver in evolutionary economic theory, co-evolving through the interaction of firms and industry structures and supporting governing institutions. Evolutionary economics is typified by the distinguishing principle of selection. Humans demonstrate goal-directed behavior, which renders selection, variation, and inheritance as interdependent mechanisms. Economic agents thus choose between alternatives, products, ideas, in one-off selections, according to a criterion of preference. Another fundamental concept of evolutionary economics is that of technological trajectories, also known as natural trajectories, defined as a pattern of innovation. Path dependency is closely associated with the concept of technological trajectory. Ontologically, individuals produce knowledge by self-organizing with one another, forming informal and formal groups, and creating new entities by enacting change. When these groups interact, in a path-dependent sequence of economic changes, temporal events can influence outcomes by chance rather than being driven by what is known as systematic forces. The basic design of a technological innovation acts as a guidepost charting the course of future innovation activity along a dependent path. One or two early models of a product or process usually stand out above all the others in the history of an industry, and their design becomes the foundation for the evolution of many other innovations. Following on from this, the concept of creative symbiosis is the case where two or more technologies combine in an integrative fashion such that the outline of the overall system is greatly simplified. When it happens, totally new possibilities for further evolution present themselves. The related notion of creative destruction is that which fuels economic change via the introduction of new patterns of behavior, be it technological, organizational, or social, which are particularly linked to decentralized and distributed practices that are regenerative, away from the former centralized models. This presentation of the foundational concepts in evolutionary economic theory revolve around technical change, at the heart of which is the historical element. Firms innovate along a given path, making use of guideposts, and over time a single dominant design develops on a technological trajectory. When there is more than one choice of innovation, a selection environment exists whereby stakeholders provide feedback to influence the direction of research and development. Technologies can also combine toward creative symbiosis. Understanding systems phenomena demands knowledge of the interactions at the component level as product and service innovations emerge. When new patterns of innovation form, causing a shift in the way things are done from a variety of perspectives, creative destruction is said to take place, giving birth to new ways and new things. Until recent times, evolutionary economics has been concerned predominantly with supply-side economic activity. However, the new evolutionary economics has sought to rebalance this endeavor by emphasizing the importance of those factors affecting the demand side. There is a need for better treatment of how households respond to an economic world that is constantly changing around them, as they themselves change. The challenge for evolutionary economists is to construct a theory of demand and supply and their interaction on markets that are not changing too erratically that is consistent with the basic tenets of evolutionary theory. From the very start, evolutionary economics was oriented to the system level. Two paramount aspects when studying innovation systems that require further research are complexity and the incorporation of non-market institutions. The lack of a system view is a significant problem, and not just for evolutionary economics, but for society at large. Thank you for listening. To download the full review or to read other theory reviews, visit open.ncl.ac.uk.